The inside of the house looks real neat right now, and they're not even halfway finished.
Are they going to actually live in there? Are mm-hmm. they going to move there?
No, they have a swimming pool and everything at their house.
So what are they going to do with that house?
It's cute, isn't it? Look at it. Mm-hmm. Look at it for cuteness. Brandi, oh. What are y'all going to do with this house? The office?
It's a playhouse.
Ah.
Maybe an office.
No, the guest house when we have guests.
Like a bed and breakfast.
We're not totally shutting that idea off.
I think you should do it.
You know, Uncle Ed was an early adopter. You know, he had this windmill, the only one when I was growing up. It was the only windmill around here, you know. And, of course, a working windmill. Mm-hmm. And I remember when I interviewed Tom Tinney in the middle 60s, he told me that, and Tom was, you know, a child of the second, my grandmother, the second wife. And he was born in 1907, and he remembered that he said Ed and Valley were the first ones to use to put up stuff canning in actual cans rather than in jars and jugs like that. And they had this canning equipment that said instead of a full lid, you know, it put a little small diameter, like a quarter size thing on a hole in the can. I've never seen anything like that, you know, in history or whatever, but he remembered that it was an unusual, and of course, apparently it was changed. It changed later, I guess, to regular lids. But he says that they were the first ones to do that. And we used to find a lot of old canned stuff around the Tinney place when Tommy and I grew up there. Jars or big half-gallon jar, they would can them in glass. But we never found any cans, anything in a can.
I haven't found anything that would do that.
Well,
I don't know what it looked like, though.
I don't either. You know, he was just describing it on this interview. Huh. It was some kind of a canning system that instead of putting a full lid on the can, it just had the lid was on it with a small hole about the size of a quarter, and that was the actual lid that they put on it when they pressurized it. It'd be interesting to do a little historical research, which I have not tried to do, but I've never even heard of that before.
That's this turn. So I'm gonna have to get that rope come over the tractor with it, or that we have that pulling this way. And then one of us is gonna have to take off back the other way whenever we get it stood up.
I'm gonna need some more weight on this end of it.
Yeah. Alicia, that rope on this side of the tractor, untie it from the trailer.
Over on this side.
Then I need to slide this all the way in.
Watch out because I'm pulling this rope.
You need to put gloves on, Ronnie. Go get your dad some gloves.
I'm in my truck.
Why can't we tie up to the trailer?
Okay, unhook it from the pallet. Unhook it to this fence post over here.
Thank you.
rope right there.
We know it broke. I got another rope up here.
Start the tractor and keep them hot dogs going.